The fourth foundation of mindfulness is an interesting one, often not fully understood. It's often given in categories, of course, with the similar to the third foundation of mindfulness, watching the mind states that arise. But it's more in it's given more in categories, such as the five hindrances, seven factors of enlightenment, the understanding and experience of the Four Noble Truths, etc., etc. But one side, or in Burma, not a Mahasi side or another tradition, was giving a talk one day, and I liked it a lot, what he was saying about this fourth foundation of mindfulness. He's was talking about the Pali for it, of course, is Dhamma Nipassana. And Dhamma means the law of nature, you know, how things actually are. And this word Nipassana means the repeated observation. So once again, with this word Nipassana, it really implies the continuity of noting, or the continuity of noticing, if you like, the phenomena or the experiences that are happening in the present moment, which is why we need to cultivate our mindfulness so we can keep up with this fast-changing phenomena that we become conscious of from moment to moment. Now, he described it as really the culmination of the other three foundations of mindfulness, of watching the body, watching the sensations, watching the mind, mental states. He described it as understanding at that level, vipassana, which is to see anicca, dukkha, and anatta, but especially anicca, impermanence. And he went on for quite some time about how important this was. And you can see it very clearly. I also like the expression that when we, in our meditation practice, when we practice in the different postures, we're actually seeing life itself, because we're experiencing these four foundations of mindfulness are actually a holistic approach to life itself. We're experiencing all the different phenomena that we experience in life, you know, the dukkha, the sukha, you know, the all the aspects of life. With this fourth foundation of mindfulness, we can begin to see much more clearly and profoundly, not just with book knowledge, but experiential insight knowledge, anicca, the impermanent nature of phenomena. When we don't see this, then it can create or be a condition once again for attachment to arise, because we're not seeing how things actually are. And this is the great teaching of the Buddha, I think, is that you're able to see anicca and dukkha, suffering. Also, you're able to see anatta, you know, the insubstantiality of things as they arise and fall in the mind. So in this sitting, what I'd like you to start to notice more clearly is impermanence, is the changing nature of things. For example, in one sitting, does things stay the same? Well, no, it doesn't. One moment you experience a sensation, one moment you're experiencing a thought, one moment an emotion may pop into the mind. No, it doesn't stay the same. All changes all the time. And you can experience this very profoundly in your practice, this teaching of the Buddha. So I like the way he explained this fourth foundation of mindfulness. It was a very clear take on what it actually means. And of course, all the categories are there, the general phenomena that arises, such as the hindrance, but they're impermanent too. The factors in enlightenment are impermanent. One moment they're very strong, next moment they fade away. another one arises, another one comes. So this teaching of impermanence is, I think, really profound in our lives. And if we can get a grasp on it and understand it through our own direct experience, it really is helpful for us, and we can move around in the world through all the ups and downs much more calmly and much more with much more, if you like, what I found, much more compassion in the world. You know, your feelings in the world are much more compassionate towards the situations that people have to face in the world. So in this sitting, I'd like you can even drop the labeling. This is like a big mind meditation, as Joseph Goldstein would talk. And just sit and allow the natural objects to come into the mind and just watch them, but notice the changing nature, not controlling anything, just watching what's going on. You think you can do that? It's really a nice practice. But let's try for a little while. Let the mind be natural. If it wants to be with rising and falling, okay. If it wants to be with the sensation, okay. If it wants to be with thought, emotion, okay. Just watch the arising and dissolving, the arising and dissolving of this phenomena. Let's take up that comfortable position again. Check your attitude here. See, are you interested? Is the mind willing to keep watching? Are you feeling tired? If you are, watch that tiredness. Weariness, watch the weariness. We have to arouse the energy. Allow the energy to come up in the mind. Sometimes you can do that just by just being with the sitting for a little bit to start with. Just notice the different sensations arising and passing away. And then move through the body a little bit. Just let the mind relax. You don't actually have to do anything except watch.